the most popular film in India last year was a film called RRR. And this was had to do with the British era, and just I'm trying to put it delicately, you weren't the nice guys in the movie. So the reason I said,
can I sit you as a South African?
Yeah. No.
Please.
I would call it rebalancing, but I would also say this is history which is switch hitting. It's hitting the other way, right?
Not far wrong.
But seriously, in history, you have these ups and downs. It's not often that actually countries get a second or a third bite of the apple. I think India today is in a very unusual position that it is once more very decisively upwardly mobile, which a lot of other civilizational states, barring one actually, are not anymore in a position to do. Where the UK is concerned, I think it's a very complex relationship. I mean, there's a lot. The most popular film in India last year was a film called RRR, and this was had to do with the British era. And just I'm trying to put it delicately, you weren't the nice guys in the movie. The reason I said...
Can I sit you as a South African?
Yeah. No.
Please.
The fact is, when you have this kind of complex history, there would be the downside of it. There would be the suspicions. There would be the unresolved problems. At the same time, there will be bonds. There will be similarities, and cricket happens to be one of them. Now, in terms of the shifting weight of cricket, when it started to shift, actually, people I think suggested we were better at the business of cricket than in the game of cricket. I think by now, barring this match, I think the game of cricket has shifted as well. So. That's the kind of things which are happening in the world today. The world is changing. There's the old, there's the new, there's the old which is now the new.